A federal grand jury has indicted Hunter Biden on felony gun charges. Now, this follows a plea deal involving a diversion agreement that absolutely fell apart for Hunter just a few weeks ago. Now, he is dealing with three counts as a result of this grand jury indictment. Biden was indicted in Delaware federal court on three counts tied to the possession of a gun while using narcotics. Two counts are tied to Biden allegedly filing a form claiming that he was not using illegal drugs at the time he purchased a Colt Cobra revolver in October of 2018. The third count alleges that he possessed a firearm while using a narcotic. And I mean, that must be a very, very serious offense in a country where we're just swimming with guns. All of these other gun owners, definitely not using any illegal narcotics, definitely not.
By the way, in case you're wondering, marijuana is illegal at the federal level.
Yep.
And hence, literally millions of people have done this crime, literally.
Schedule one drug. It is considered a Schedule one drug.
Yes. And when there is no other underlying crime, like a bank robbery or something else that you use the gun for, this is pretty much never charged, never. But all of a sudden you have a Trump appointed special prosecutor and the Republicans want some sort of political payback, and we're charging the lowest crime in American history. All right, have fun. Boy, you got him, Republicans.
Now look, I think this is their attempt to essentially get more, I mean, it's part of their fishing expedition. So as a result of this indictment, I'm sure many of you might have heard of various Republican lawmakers calling for his financial documents to be subpoenaed, even though they've already subpoenaed so many of his financial documents. They've pored over his financial documents. They have failed to show any wrongdoing, or at least wrongdoing tying Joe Biden to Hunter Biden in any incriminating way. I want to also just go back to the plea deal that fell apart, just in case you might have missed that angle to the story. So as I mentioned, about last month, there was a plea deal that absolutely fell apart. And it was a plea deal that special counsel Michael Weiss had agreed to, although there seemed to have been some sort of miscommunication. The two sides reached a plea agreement in July, which called for Hunter Biden to plead guilty in Delaware federal court to two misdemeanor counts of failing to pay his taxes in return for prosecutors recommending a sentence of probation. Now, a separate felony gun charge, and that's the gun charge that he's now been indicted for illegally owning a Colt Cobra 38 special handgun, would have been dropped in 2 years if Biden honored the terms of what's known as a diversion agreement. Now, it all kind of fell apart as a result of, I guess, a miscommunication between the prosecutors and the defense. Now, the judge overseeing the case took a look at the plea agreement and had some questions. The agreements are not straightforward and they contain some atypical provisions, US District Judge Mary Ellen Norica noted, including one that could theoretically protect Biden from other tax-related crimes in the same time period. And so prosecutors said the provision in the diversion agreement would not protect him from different charges, while attorneys for Hunter Biden said it would. That miscommunication essentially led to the plea deal falling apart. And because of political pressure from the Republican Party toward Michael Weiss, the special counsel decided to move ahead with a grand jury, and the grand jury did decide to indict Hunter Biden on this gun charge.
Yeah, so that plea deal had a huge problem, which is that it was super vague. You didn't know what it applied to. Did it apply to all charges against Hunter Biden or just these nonsense charges? So I think the judge made the right decision in the earlier case. I think the plea deal was deeply flawed, but in a normal case, they would never prosecute anyone on this. And so he's doing it because of political pressure or because he's a weirdo right winger who wants to get Hunter Biden no matter what. By the way, there's a third possibility that the Republicans have now latched onto, and we're the fairest show in America, so we'll give you that one too. They think that even though Trump appointed him, he's secretly on Biden's side and he's charging him with this because he doesn't want to charge him with anything that could connect him to Joe Biden. Or the more likely explanation is he doesn't have any evidence right connecting him to Joe Biden. And you guys have dug and dug and dug, and you've got all, you asked for every kind of evidence, you got every kind of evidence. By the way, including bank records. They're still crying about bank records, but they got a ton of bank records And none of them showed any connection between Hunter Biden and Joe Biden. The laptop shows there's no connection. But look, the Republican Party these days, it's, look, you watch this show regularly, you will see us criticize Democrats harsher than almost any other show, including a lot of right wing shows, right? And Hunter, we got no love for at all. He ran scams to no end with the art and the gas and all that stuff, right? But guys, they don't have any evidence. And the Republican Party today, this current Republican Party, they just lie as a regular course of business. We've never seen anything like this. The politicians lie regularly to begin with, but this is a whole new level. They took it to 11.
They did.
Like, they just say it with no shame at all. None of this is true. Hunter is not connected to Joe Biden, and this charge is absolute trash.
In fact, I actually want to call a specific person out. And it's, look, the lawmakers are gonna do what they do, right? This is a politicized prosecution. I think it's pretty clear at this point. But in regard to right-wing media, just today I saw a tweet from Ben Shapiro that was concerning. Because Ben Shapiro really likes to present himself as more of a good faith member of conservative media. He does better than others, you know, definitely better than, like, let's say Michael Knowles. However, he lied in that
or
tweet.
Or anyone else he's ever hired, but okay.
No, that's true. That's,
Matt Walsh.
That's it. Now, in his tweet, he said, you know, people keep saying that there's no evidence incriminating Joe Biden. And then he lists, like, he has bullet points proving that there is evidence. And in that list, he included the testimony by Devin Archer, a former business partner of Hunter Biden's. You guys, Devin Archer's testimony was garbage. He did not say what Republican lawmakers investigating the Biden family were hoping he would say. He said the exact opposite of what they were hoping he would say. In fact, his testimony was so bad, and the Republican lawmakers doing the investigation knew it was gonna be so bad, that James Comer, the head of the committee investigating Hunter Biden, didn't even show up for the testimony. So how are you gonna list Devin Archer as evidence incriminating Joe Biden?
Yeah, you never see us defending the Democratic Party unjustly. You never see us make excuses for politicians when they're being cheesy, lying, you name it, etc. But look, I'm sorry, but it's just a reality. Right-wing politicians and right-wing media, it's just based on a factory of lies. So that testimony, and Ben Shapiro, look, to his credit, is a smart guy. He's too smart not to know that it was a humiliating testimony. James Comer literally didn't show up because it was so humiliating. And he, look, every piece of so-called evidence that they cite is not gonna stand up in court, because that's why it's not being brought as charges, because exactly. There is no goddamn evidence. It's total horse crap, like Joe Biden called Hunter Biden. It's his son, of course he called him. He calls him daily, he calls every family member daily. Are you guys like, oh, I call his daughter daily, I wonder what she's up to? Look, the politicians overall are cheesy. They are generally corrupt. Joe Biden has taken hundreds of millions of dollars in campaign contributions, and he has delivered for those donors. That is legalized bribery. He participates in it just like almost every other politician does. You wanna hit him on that, I agree with you, and I will back that up. But you wanna invent things, and you wanna just make up reality and lie to your audience 24/7 and poison their minds with things that aren't true. Sorry, no, you're full of crap. And be careful what you wish for. I mean, there are no strong Democrats in this country, but God help you if there is one day, because you can literally put away millions of Republicans on that same charge.
Millions of
literally
Americans.
Millions.
Yeah, literally millions of Americans, like, who again partake in the use of illegal narcotics as it pertains to our federal government, and certainly have possession of firearms.
So there's no use in talking to right-wing media or politicians. They don't care about what's facts, etc. They're just trying to make money, right? So, but right-wing voters, I don't know that you care about principles at all anymore. I don't know, it's up to you guys. But guys, like making a mistake on a gun form. He had the gun for 11 days and then threw it away. Did not commit any crimes with that gun, and none of you have been smoked pot at all while having a gun. None of you have ever made a mistake on one of those forms. Come on, you know that if he did this to you, you would go ballistic. You'd say it was the tyranny of government taking your rights away, trying to put you in prison for getting for a tiny mistake on a gun form with no other underlying crime with that gun. Get out of here, you don't believe that. You know you don't believe that.
This is honestly, and I've said this before, I'm gonna say it again. And I'm trying to be understanding of the conservative voters' mindset as they get riled up by the misinformation they're fed by right-wing media and GOP politicians, right? This is their version of the Russian collusion investigation. You get what I'm saying? And so think about how the way that Russia collusion story was covered, especially on outlets like MSNBC, really made people think like, no, there's a lot of smoke here, there must be fire. So I wanna be understanding toward them, because the propaganda is there and the propaganda is fierce and it's just wall to wall nonsense about how, you know, I mean, people genuinely think there's already evidence available. There isn't, and I want to see it. Like, I have no problem pointing to the evidence myself and saying, you know what, here's what they found. This does not look good for Hunter Biden. This does not look good for Joe Biden. That evidence doesn't exist, guys.
Yeah.
If there is the Devin Archer testimony, show me where Devin Archer said, oh yeah, totally, Joe Biden as vice president was selling his influence to foreign agents in order to cash in to the tune of tens of millions of dollars. Show me, I'd love to see it. Prove me wrong, I have no problem correcting our errors on this show.
Yeah.
But it just doesn't exist. By the way, I will correct one error that I've already made in this story, and that is the name of the special counsel. It's not Michael Weiss, it's David Weiss. I don't know why I keep wanting to call him Michael, but it's David Weiss.
Yeah, so last things here, guys. Look, I thought in the Trump Russia situation, there was a lot of smoke. But when it turned out that there was no fire, what did we do? We told you there was no fire. And that's not that hard. That's not that hard. You go, oh wait, his sons are saying that they get all their money from the Russians and 100 other things. Oh, Hunter Biden is a crook, it seems like a crook, that's fair. And he's talking about the big guy and calling the big guy, and that sounds weird. But then at the end, you have to see, is there a fire or isn't there? So when our side sees there's no fire, no, I shouldn't speak for our side, I should speak for us. When we see there's no fire, we tell you honestly, right, there's no fire. Their side sees there's no fire. They're like, oh great, let's keep lying to them about the fire.
Right.
Let alone the fact that we lied about the smoke to begin with. So,
I mean, it's the Benghazi treatment.
Yeah, and guys, last thing on this. If the special prosecutor has Hunter on corruption, for God's sake, charge him, okay? I don't want any corruption in this country, and I certainly don't want to connect to the president of the United States. If you have the evidence and you don't charge him, that would be a travesty of justice. If you don't have the evidence, shut up and drop these stupid charges that you know are trash, and let's move on with our lives.
Thanks for watching the video, guys. We also love it if you hit the join button below, because that makes you a member, and members allow us to be independent, honest. We could be as progressive as we want, no corporate media influence, and that's all because of you guys. We love doing the show with our members. Hit the join button, become one of the Young Turks.